Hey guys, Ralph here. Welcome to True Power Trumpet Fitness and Fabulous Friday here in Connecticut. Life's good when you have double C's. And you saw the thumbnail. 2020, the year of the double C. Guys, 4 years. This is my fifth year that I've started this. And guys, as great as the results are, everybody can be doing better. Everybody can be doing better. Just stick to the concepts, and you got it. Anyway, let me honk. I've done some SFE. I've done some spit buzzing. I played a little bit. Let's see what we got. To play a stronger double C than that. I love it, baby. You drinking fruits and vegetables? Anyway, loud double C's. Drop down into play, and that was at number seven, five, seven, five. Okay, ending on another double C after playing several lines of barbed wire. Guys, that's it. Anyway, a couple things. First of all, my health and fitness, and specifically my diet, is going great on the other channel. And I'm warning you right now, I am going to put a health and fitness video up on this channel as soon as I get this done. Okay? Now, here's the deal. A lot of you, and that's why I'm putting on this channel, a lot of you have tried the cleanse and have come back to me, Ralph, it's just too hard. I can't stay on it. Well, I've got an alternative to cleanse that is fabulous. That is fabulous. I call it J24, okay? And I'm not going to get into it here. If that's something you're interested in, check the video when it comes up later on today. Okay? 2020, year of the double C. Guys, I am so excited about this. So excited about this. And for the most part, guys, my young kids are just killing things. Killing things. They're doing all district that and all you know, solo competition this and just killing things. Not getting the least bit nervous because they're so strong and they're so secure. You know, hiding trumpet concerto for high school, easy. He didn't get nervous. He's got a, now, not one of them has a legitimate double C yet. All of them will. And probably by this time next year. As I said, I can almost guarantee they will do it in 2020. Now, here's the deal. I don't usually put a time limit on it, as you know. I've gotten screwed so many times. Go ahead, take that New Year's Eve big band gig. Tell them you can play lead. You'll have it by then, and they don't have it by then. See what I mean? Okay, now, here's the deal. The reason that I can put a time limit on the kids is because they, for the most part, are a clean slate with their chops. Okay? Many of them started with me. And if they didn't start with me, then they hadn't taken private lessons before me, so there was nobody there to screw them up with tightening the corners and Bach mouthpieces and stuff. So the clean slate, they're just off to the races. Is this right, Mr. Salamone? Yeah, that's right. And they get some funky notes, and they come back next week, and they're playing Fs above high C. I mean, that's just the way it works. When you have no prior gunk, drivel to plow through, to get to what we're trying to do. Now, you comeback players, little different story. Little different story. If you've been studying with this guy and that guy and you know, Caruso this and Roy Stevens, guys, you have a lot of stuff to get rid of before you even get to the right things. Now, what usually happens with the comeback guys, yes, I can get them from a low C to a G on top of the step playing correctly. But they're so used to playing, you know, above that and whatnot, even though it's wrong, you see? So they start playing wrong, and before you know it, they're back, and they're blaming the mouthpiece, they're doing this. No, guys, it's not the mouthpiece. The mouthpiece doesn't change. You change, and all of a sudden you can't play. Guys, you have to play correctly in your happy zone. You have to have the patience to do that. But your happy zone sounds so much better than it has previously. Guys, you can get away with not playing lead for a couple months if that's the case. Or splitting the lead with another guy, whatever, until you get it going. Because the Bailey is going to love your chops. Love your chops. And you guys that are playing concert bands, when your high note is a high C. Now, concert bands can be demanding. Concert bands, depending on how many trumpets they have there, they can be very, very demanding. Okay? A Sousa March can put Maynard on his butt. Absolutely can. And when you get into some of these old war horses, you know, Poet and Peasant and Semiramide and all this sort of stuff, guys, you're playing clarinet, you're playing violin parts, they get very, very demanding, and there's very, very little rest in a lot of those arrangements. And if your band director isn't privy to what a trumpet player is going through, yes, it can get a little weird. It can absolutely get a little weird, okay? Now, pros. Pros can be tough too, okay? I've taught lots of pros. And even though they desperately want to improve, there's a couple things going on, okay? Number one, it's hard to try a new mouthpiece if you've got Parsifal that night. See, now, I can go here and Jerry can tell me, I still act like he's right around the corner. Anyway, would tell me that, try a new mouthpiece or try a new, and, you know, I'd clam, and if I had to play that night, I might be in some trouble. But now that I don't play anymore, yes, I can do all that, and it's no sweat. But I completely understand why a pro would not just want to Monday play a Bach 3C and then Tuesday go to the 1SB. I get it. I get it completely, okay? Number two, usually a professional has reached a level of success without doing it, okay? So they are very, very weary of maybe taking a step back in order to see the big picture and eventually get up a plateau or so. So it can get, again, the kids are the easiest. The kids are the easiest. My favorite one years ago, it was a good, I'm gonna say 25 years now. He was a high school kid. And a very, very talented kid, but had no chops. No chops. When I got him, he had about an A or a B flat above the staff, as soft as could be. Now, one thing about him, he was not stretching. But now, I will say this, he was not the brightest bulb in the package. And again, like I said, is that right, miss? Is that in the right place? Yeah, try it. Squeak, squawk, squawk. That doesn't sound right. No, that's right. Keep doing it. By the end of the lesson, you sound pretty good up to the A or B flat, nice and full. When I saw him the next week, F above high C as big as a house. In 2 months, he was playing double C and playing Alan Vizzuti solos in the jazz band. Getting number one in Allstate, number one at the Berklee Jazz Festival for lead player. In no time at all. All because, number one, he just followed directions, okay? And he wasn't stretching to begin with. So you just add the tongue to it, and he was ready to go. All right? The year of the double C, baby. Come on. Every single one of you. There's no reason you can't be playing double C's just as big as that and everything in between. All right? Let's do it, baby. Let's do it. You and I, I'll show you how to do it. I'll take you by the hand. You know what's going on. If you do not have True Power to the Max or do not have the Double C Manifesto, $10, get it. Okay? Relax the corners. If that's your bottom lip, and that's your tongue, the tip of the tongue presses in to the bottom lip, which will also grip the top lip while you're at it. With relaxed corners. Hang on. Yeah. Tell me who this looks like. Just looks like. That's Maurice. That's just Maurice. That's what it looks like. Okay? And don't overblow. And you got it, man. You got it. All right? Eat and drink your fruits and vegetables and live your life with true power. And if you have any interest at all on a tweak, use that before, tweak to the juice cleanse is going to make life a lot easier. Check out the one that I put up later today. Okay? I'll see you. Have a great weekend. I'll see you Monday. Love you all.